Hello everybody. We'll just wait for a couple of minutes for people to join in. Hello. Hello Shreya. Maithili. Anvi, Pranita. Hello, hello everybody. Great, great. So I can see people are joining in. Very good. Hi Moshmi, Sejal, Archana. Great, great, great. So, as you all know, today I had thought this to be an introductory session for Kathak, but I thought let's do something fun and let us ask the followers of Nitya Rupam and all the people who have joined in, what would you like to learn today? So we can maybe divide the session into different parts. We can start off with some basic movements and then move on to composition. I want some comments. What would you like to learn? Hello, Unnati. Hello, Nupur. Hi, hi. Hello, everybody. Great. So, until everybody joins in, expression parts, Maithili. Okay. Expressions, very good. People are still joining in, so I think. Let us give them some time. So, as we all know about the origin of Kathak, hand movements, okay, fine. So, I think instead of focusing on introduction of the dance form, we will focus on some techniques which include the technical dance as well as some expressions. Different types of footwork. Okay, so why not? Let's divide the session into three parts. First part, we will focus on the expressions. Second half, first part, we'll focus on some expressions. Second part will be about hand movements, and the third will be dedicated to footwork. Archana, combinations of Adavu. Archana, Adavus are a part of Bharatanatyam. And Bharatanatyam sister dance styles. We do not follow Adavus in Kathak. Variety of footwork. Okay, fine. Expressions. Great, great. So let's start. I would like to say that whenever we are doing any kind of abhinay, we should know the exact meaning of the word. Now the meaning is so vast, it's really difficult to write down the definition or even explain, because there are so many different layers which have been given to the word itself. Abhi means towards, and nay means to take or to lead. So to lead towards the meaning, or lead closer towards the meaning of a word, of a certain word, is basically a broad definition of abhinay. In dance, basically we use angik abhinay. Angik, which is related to the anga, which will include your face, all the smaller parts, your eyes, as in your expressions. It will also include your body language, your hand movements, the way you walk, or whatever movement that you are doing. For example, if you have to show an old woman, she won't maybe be standing erect, she'll be crouched a bit. Or if you're going to show a prop, that she's holding a cane, that way. Tell some theory, for example, Kuchipudi dancers. Okay. Sorry dear, this session is for Kathak and I am not well versed with theory exams for Kuchipudi. So I won't be able to cover that. Anyway, coming back, so that becomes your body language. Now we're coming to the expressions part. So this is a part of angik abhinay, whatever expressions that we use. When I was doing when I was learning आगे कभिनय, I would actually connect various incidents of my personal life with the character which I was portraying. So for example, if I wanted to be sad, I used to think about something sad which has happened in my life, and that used to, you know, bring out the body language in me. So you should learn to connect. That is the first and foremost thing of Aange Kabhinay, which I really like, which I use. Second thing which I used to do is I used to imagine, if I had not gone through that particular circumstance, I used to imagine myself in that position and how my character or how I would react to that situation. That would also help. So if I'm being sad, let me just remove my glasses. So if I'm being sad, this will happen. Okay, my body language will be a bit crouched. I will be my back won't be straight, my spine won't be straight, I'm not feeling cheerful. And so maybe I'm thinking about a chapter which I should have studied during the exam, before the exam, but I just ignored that chapter, and now that chapter has come for a 20 mark question and I'm feeling sad. Oh God, I should have done that. Okay, that may help you with Kalahantarita Nayika, who is, you know, who has just quarreled with her Nayak and who is feeling sad. I really should not have said that to him. Now he is angry and I am alone here. Okay, so that regret part, the sadness part, so that joins in, that correlates with each other. Another thing is, if you're being happy, different characters will express happiness in different ways. Okay, so a certain character will be bubbly, and if it is a guy, he might want to control his emotions, because in, let's face it, in our society, boys do not really express completely. That is what I personally feel. Every boy does not like to express his feelings completely. However, if it is a female character, she'll be so happy, she'll be chubby, she'll be bubbling, and she'll laugh, she'll be happy, her eyes will be excited, her eyebrows will be raised, and what to do, what should I do, it's raining after such a long time. So that excitement, that that feeling you get when you are anticipating something and it really happens, so that is going to be a combination of your excitement and your happiness. So how will you get that? An example, I was really hoping that my parents would get me a certain watch, let's say a certain watch for my birthday. I was really wishing they, you know, they'll get me that. And suddenly on my birthday, they actually present me with the same watch which I wanted. So how is that going to reflect? Oh my God, I just wanted this watch. This is so nice. And I wear it and I'm admiring it. It is so nice. Now, this watch can be a necklace your Nayika wants, an earring which your Nayika wants and she's happy, a nathni which she's wearing and she's happy and she's showing to people, see, my Nayak got me this. Okay, that is how you can correlate happiness with something which you have done. Third thing is, if you have not, as I said, if you've not been through that circumstance, you can actually imagine people standing there and practice focusing with your eyes. So like right now, I am focusing in the camera while I'm talking to every one of you. I can't see your face. I can't see your eyes. I can just see your comments, right? However, I'm imagining that I can see Akanksha. I can see Nidhi. I can see Rishi. Okay, I can see all of these people, who are waving out, all of these people who are saying hi. So I can see everybody and I'm talking to you. So if it helps, you can just practice having conversations that way, having conversations with yourself in front of the mirror where you focus in your eyes when you're talking to yourself, okay? Because in Abhinaya, you really want your audience to know that that person is there. You want your audience to believe that the person is there. So unless I believe that Krishna is actually standing there and I'm looking at him. Unless I believe Krishna is standing there, my audience are not going to believe that. Okay, so I really need to imagine that that Krishna, Lord Krishna, is standing there with his flute, and he is playing his flute. He is completely immersed in that, and I'm just looking at him. So those expressions are really not going to come unless you imagine. That's the third tip I would like to give for expressions. And the fourth tip is having dialogues. Okay, so while this is a technique that my guru Shambhavi Dandekar, she taught me, that you actually have certain dialogues fixed with certain movements. For example, if I'm doing a Gatabhav, and so Krishna comes, Krishna calls his all of his friends, and he says, "See, over there, that is where the makhan is kept. Now every one of us should go and make a pyramid. I will climb up and I will get it down, and all of us can eat." Now all of this you have to say without the dialogues, okay? Calling his friends, addressing to them that the makhan is right there. So you're pointing, you're also pointing with your eyes, your eyebrows are raised because you're showing something, you're indicating something. All of us, let's make a pyramid. I will climb on top, get the pot down, and then all of us can have it. Okay, so these are the dialogues which really happen. There's one really funny incident that I would like to say, I would like to share with you everybody. So in my video of the Gadbhav of Draupadi Vastraharan, there is one point where she says, don't come near me, okay, because Dushasan is trying to pull her sari, he's trying to undress her, and she says, "Don't." So that "don't" is so etched in my mind, and whenever I am performing that Gatabhav, and when Dushasan comes, when I imagine Dushasan coming, in my mind I'm saying, don't touch me. So these dialogues are a really, really, really good way to bring out the expressions, because unless you are saying the dialogue in your mind, it's really difficult for the audience to see what you are having, what you are thinking, not what you are having. I hope I have done justice to the expression part. If there are any questions regarding the expressions and Abhinaya, you can ask me. I'll give you about a couple of minutes for that. One more thing I would like to say is how we are showing different characters in the dance form. So if you're showing a male character, his body language will be straight, he'll be standing up like this. If you're showing a female character, she'll more likely be a little bit bent towards the lasyang. That's how you are going to express the gender of the character. So that is also a very important part. Okay, I don't think there are any questions regarding the expressions part which we already which we've discussed. In case you think of questions, how to uplift and do things with our eyebrows. Okay, wow. So I started with this. Okay. And you can just hold this eyebrow, okay, here in place, and try to lift the other one. You'll be surprised to know I really can't lift one eyebrow at once. I've been practicing Kathak for 23 years and I really can't. So it's just a matter of practice, and maybe, you know, it differs from person to person. Okay. When I listen and perform on a song for the first time, it's more expressive, but later on several times I practice, it gets low. Yes, so that may happen because the first time we are dancing, it is going to be extempore, Okay, it is expressive, yes. So it is an extempore dance, because you are really feeling the song and you haven't choreographed the song, you are just expressing yourself. Okay, so that newness is present. So that newness, you should try to, you know, don't try to box it up. What I try to do is, if you see the same performance of my two songs, it might be different, because I believe in doing upaj. So whatever I feel at that moment, I just end up doing it, and it is, and I really love doing it. So if you have seen some of my videos, some of my solos, not group dances, of course, one being Let It Go in Frozen. So that was a number which I really had not choreographed. I had just choreographed a couple of actions, and then I had decided that I'm just going to go on stage and do whatever I want, you know, whatever I feel like doing, while still keeping the beat. So my hand movements, there are a couple of glitches in the choreography, you might have noticed. That is because of that, because that was not a practiced choreography. So you need to, you know, whenever you perform on that song again, you have to think of it as you're performing it for the first time. Don't try to recollect whatever you have done earlier on, because you might feel differently. So that newness needs to be incorporated in every performance. How to work with eyebrows? Yes, Anushka, as I said, it's just a matter of practice. So this, keep doing this. Excuse me. We had, I think in Visharad or in Alankar, you have Bhrukuti se barabar dugun chogun karna. So that you can do. Okay, so you can do na, dhin, dhin, na. This becomes the barabar, then na, dhin, dhin, na. And then go on to chaugun, na, dhin, dhin, na, na, dhin, dhin, na. You know, that is going to help you with controlling your muscles more. And one thing is, you can just hold on to your eyebrow and try practicing one, this and this. Even I practice this, but still I'm not able to, you know, do it individually. How to use eyebrows in all Nayikas? So use of eyebrows will be related to the mood of the Nayika. Okay, so it is not that, as I said, just because you want to use eyebrows somewhere, that I'm going to use in all Nayikas. Don't do that. So this answer is going to be related to the one I have given earlier, that maintain the newness. Maybe you will not feel like using your eyebrows to show a certain Nayika at that time. So you don't really need to, you know, bother about, I did not use my eyebrows in this particular Nayika. Don't think in that way. Okay, we're done with eyebrows. Ma'am, please let us know about types of Nayikas. Okay, so Nayikas have been described in many, many texts. And right now, the standard definitions which we follow are according to the Natya Shastra, which was written sometime during 400 BC to 400 AD. Again, there are people who believe it was written from 200 BC to 200 AD, 200 to 400 BC to 400 AD. So I just like to include all the years in it there. And I say from 400 BC to 400 AD. So it was written sometime during that time. And later on, many other versions, many other texts were written, like the Sangeet Ratnakar was written, or Rasamanjari was written, which also describe different types of Nayikas. So today, which we follow, the Nayikas which we follow, the Ashta Nayikas, are really well known. These are according to the Natya Shastra. So the order in which these Nayikas are given, it is not compulsory that the that every woman is going to go through all of those stages in that particular chronological order. The stages may vary, or a certain Nayika might not go through one particular stage at all. For example, if she's not fighting with her husband at all, so she will not go, she will not be a Kalahantarita in any time. That also may happen. So there are categories of Nayikas given in many different, according to many different sections or elements. according to the age of the Nayika, according to her body structure, then according to her behavior. So now, according to the behavior, there are one is Sviya Nayika, the Swaki, or it is also called the Swakiya Nayika. The Sviya Nayika is a Nayika who is loyal to her husband. She does not even think about any other man, you know, she might encounter. She is true to her husband. And the Ashtanayikas are subdivisions of this Sviya Nayika. Very, very few people know this, but this is a very important point that, you know, everybody should remember. Now, I will just, you know, in random order, I'll just tell you the Nayikas. One is Swadhina Patika Nayika. Jiska pati uske swadhin hota hai. So that Nayika is going to her husband is going to help her, you know, in her daily chores. That she says, okay, my feet are hurting, I won't be able to walk today, will you come with me? So he accompanies her. They go to you know, the water source. And oh my god, this is really heavy, I can't carry it, can you please carry it for me? The Nayika will say, of course I will carry it for you, and they'll go back, and so on. That is the Swadhina Patika Nayika. One Nayika is the Proshita Patika Nayika, or it is called, there are, you know, certain variations in the names, so I've learnt it as Proshita Patika Nayika. Jiska Nayak kaam ke silsile mein usse dur gaya hai, that is the Proshita Patika Nayika. So he is not with her, and she is feeling really dull. She does not like, she does not like to do anything, she does not like to dress up, and she is thinking about him every time, and she is waiting for him to come back. That's the Proshita Patika Nayika. One is the Virohot Kanthita Nayika. Now the main difference between Virohot Kanthita Nayika and the Proshita Patika Nayika. In the Virohot Kanthita Nayika, her Nayak or her husband, she doesn't know where he is. She is just estranged from him. And she does not eat properly, because every time she is thinking about him for the entire day. She is not eating properly. Her health is deteriorating. Her, you know, she's losing weight. And she also doesn't know when he's going to come back. She doesn't know how to reach him. So in Proshita Patika Nayika, you can say that she'll send him a letter. That is possible. But in Virohot Kanthira Nayika, she really doesn't know how to reach him. As I was saying, the main difference between them is the Proshita Patika Nayika has drawn lines on the walls signifying the number of days that the Nayak is going to be apart from her. So for example, she has drawn 10 lines, so he is going to be away for 10 days, and with every passing day, she is going to rub off one line. Okay, so that, okay, now only 7 days are remaining, now only 6 days are remaining for him to come back. As opposed to this, the Virohot Kanthita Nayika is drawing lines on the walls, signifying that, okay, it's one day that we are apart, now 2 days we are apart, 3 days we are apart, etc., etc., and so on, okay? Then the Vipralabdha Nayika, where the Nayak has called her to a certain place at a certain time, she goes there to meet him, but for some unforeseen situation, he does not turn up. And a doubt arises in her mind that maybe he has forgotten me and he is with somebody else. He has found another Nayika maybe. Now why he is not coming, or why he does not turn up to that particular place, that reason is unknown. Nobody knows that reason. It can be a genuine reason that, you know, he might not have been able to travel because of some natural calamity maybe. But the Nayika is not thinking about that. She is thinking that maybe he has cheated on me. Then I think we've done 4 Nayikas. Fifth one, we'll say the Abhisarika Nayika. The Nayika who, you know, dresses up and goes to meet her Nayak by avoiding the eyes of everybody and hiding from everybody. And whatever obstacles come in her way, she tries to. She overcomes them and goes and meets her Nayak. That is the Abhisarika Nayika. Then we have the Khandita Nayika. Now in Natya Shastra, it is just given that the Nayika whose husband has been with some other woman and the previous night, and who returns home in the at dawn is the Khandita Naika. Now why she is called Khandita or how she is going to react, this is not really given in the text. So how she is going to react is really up to our interpretation or the interpretation of the choreographer. So you can say that she gets angry and she says, go away, I don't want to see you at all. Then she is breaking their relation, that's why she is called Khandita. Or being the classic example of an Indian woman, Indian Sanskari woman, she'll say that, okay, fine, come inside, this is your home. She'll close the door and, you know, she'll still, she'll just go on with her normal life. But uska maan khandan hota hai. That is why also she's called Khandita. That's another interpretation. Then the Kalahantarita Naika. Kalaha is a quarrel. So when she quarrels with her husband and then later on she regrets it. That is the Kalahantarita Naika. And the last one is the Vasaka Sajja Naika, who has who has gotten a message that from her Nayak that he is going to come. And so she dresses up and she decorates the entire house and she is waiting for him. That is the Vasaka Sajja Naika. So that's about it. How to bring the expressions during any bhavang by imagining the situation. So imagination is going to be a very, you know, something which you should develop on your own. Maybe you can practice focusing your eyes by looking at yourself in the mirror, focusing in your eyes, and then trying the same, maybe facing a wall. You can maybe try that, imagining things. One more thing is, if you are imagining yourself in that particular situation, so that is something that this is a very individual thing, and you have to, you know, keep working on it continuously. Even I work on my abhinay and my expressions continuously. So you'll have to come up with that. Ma'am, what expression should we give during a bowl? Okay, so whenever we are dancing any bowl, the purpose of that dance is not to express any emotion, any particular emotion, right? So how to interpret different movements, so that is something which you know, I encourage my students to do, that you are supposed to link your movements to certain things which you can see around yourself. For example, there's this one hastak which goes this way. So here what I tell my students, that you're having chocolates, you take one chocolate and you're offering it to that person, to a person in front of you or to a person who's standing in front of you. So that's the expression, take the chocolate, same with your left hand, take the chocolate. Okay, so these are certain things which I follow. Or while doing tram, I really imagine a fully bloomed lotus flower. So that's the expression which comes to my mind. And while doing these actions, I just imagine that I'm pulling something up. Okay, or as you know, this hastak I've already explained in one of my hastak tutorials. So that the happiness of not, you know, allowing that object to fall while doing this movement is going to get that expression on your face, I'm sure. Okay, I hope I've answered your question. Which gharana do you follow? I have learned the Nataraj Gopi Krishna ji Shaili, which follows the Banaras and Lucknow gharanas from my guru, Guru Shambhavi Dandekar and Guru Pandita Manisha Sathe ji. I trained under her for 16 years, then under 2 years under Manisha Thai. And now I'm training under Guru Pandit Rajendra Gangani ji of the Jaipur Gharana. What a person should do after Prabhakar degree? In my personal opinion, degree is are fine, but you know, you should still keep practicing and still keep working on yourself, because honestly, when people inquire about my classes, they really don't ask me what my degree is, or you know, have I completed Visharad, have I completed Alankar, have I completed my master's in Kathak. Guys, I'm just going to shut the window, too much disturbance coming in, sorry. Yeah, so I hope that's better. Anyway, so as I was saying, they really don't ask your degree. So if you want to practice Kathak professionally, work on your art, keep working on your hastaks, keep working on your expressions. Like, for example, this chocolate expression, interpretation, I mean, you can, you know, link it with any other thing. And one more thing is, if we do tram thai tat thai, so tram thai tat thai. So imagine a flower, a lotus flower. I'm giving a lotus flower to somebody. I'm passing it on to a person above, and then again passing it down. Okay, so this is called passing the parcel. Everyone must have played that game when they were little. We might, you know, we even play it nowadays with our family and stuff. So give, get it back. So when you're taking something back, a slight movement of your neck is also involved. Okay, you will not, okay, give, take, give, take. Your hands won't go like a robot. So imagine you are giving your daughter or your sister or your friend, you're just giving a flower to them, then passing it on to somebody, and then again passing it on here. So that is a game which you have to play. Second thing is, people have asked me about hand movements, so I would like to tell them that, you know, make fists of your hands and try to focus your energy on your wrist. Okay, so if you do this, a normal PT exercise which we used to do in school for warm up, now open your hands and it will become this. Okay, one more thing is, if you're doing this movement, try to relax your elbows, because if you don't relax your elbows, it will become a curve. However, we want it to be a line which is drawn by the wrist. Okay, now when you're pulling it back, I tell people to imagine that they are in a gym. Okay, and that they're holding the instrument and exercising. So pull, you're pulling an elastic. So that is how your pull should be. Every pull should be this way, driven by the wrist, not by the fingers. When you are opening your hands for thai thai or tat tat, don't move your shoulders. Okay, I tell my students that you have to open it like you're opening a door. So open, close, open, close. By doing all of this, your chin should completely be aligned to the to your shoulder, and this, and open, and open. Okay, so if you're opening both your hands together, it will be this way. Most of the times I can see people doing this. Okay, this is because you're moving your elbow. So that these are the hinges of the door which are fixed, they're not going to move. Just the arm will move, not your elbows. Okay, that's another tip which I follow. Ma'am, tell something about Gatanikas. Which gharana do you follow? I've already answered the gharana question. So about Gatanikas. Gatanikas, gat means gati, means speed. And nikas means nikalna. Okay, or to go towards something. So Gatanikas is an open-ended composition in Kathak, and for the detailed definition, actually you can just refer to my Gatanikas post. I have pura detail mein definition diya hai wahan pe. So I will not go into details of Gatanikas right now in the live session. How to keep face so sharp and eyes in the pointed direction during Talang? Yes. So you know, changing of the focus is very important when you are doing the talang. So as I said, practice in front of a mirror, practice focusing in your eyes. Okay, that is one thing. Second thing you can do is focus on your hands. So there are two types of movements. One movement is where you are showing a certain point. Okay, for example, this. So here, this point is important. The path is not important. So that point will be your focal point. Okay, so thai, I'm looking at that point. So there your focus should be. Practice actually looking at your hands to improve your focus. The second type of action is where the path is important. So this is important. I'm giving something. So now when you're giving something to somebody, you're obviously going to, you know, look at your hand and look at them when you're giving it. You can't look here, you can't look in front and give somebody something. That's just stupid, you know? So imagine things that that you know make you connected with your dance. That is going to help you a lot in Talang. Your face needs to relax. Most of the times what happens is we are thinking about maybe our bending, because we're coordinating our bending, our balance, our hand movements, our tatkar or foot movements. If there are chakras, then we're also thinking about how we are going to balance ourselves. So all of these thoughts, no matter what is going on in your mind, your face should always be this way. Okay, because I remember going blank on stage. Okay, and I'm like, okay, I don't know what comes next. What's the movement? But my face is like this. People should not come to know what is going on in my mind. I should not be, oh my God, what's the next movement? What's the next movement? No, just, you know, relax and keep a smile on your face. Most of the times we are, when we're doing live shows, you have that, that freeness of taking one more avartan to, you know, think about what the next movement is going to be. Actually remember the next movement. So that is going to help you. Gharana, ma'am, your gharana. I've already answered that question. Can you recommend some books for theoretical studies? A book by Guru Dr. Puru Dadhich and Guru Dr. Vibha Dadhich is really good. Kathak Nritya Shiksha Part 1 and Part 2. Both of these books are available on Amazon. I have checked the availability. Just checked whether they are available in your city or not. Then one book is Kathak Darpan Deepika by Guru Dr. Rohini Bhatte. That is also a very good book. Then Nritya Saurabh by Dr. Manjari Dev ji, that is also a really good book to follow. In what year do they start teaching Abhinay? So Abhinay actually first year se hi shuru ho jata hai, when because in the portion there is one Abhinay Geet. But to actually understand Abhinay and to be able to reciprocate it properly, according to me, it requires at least 3 to 4 years to properly understand. Even though the first year we are doing the Abhinay Geet, and the second year we are doing the Kavit, we are doing the Gata Bhav. So actually, Abhinay, the training starts from the first year, but understanding and reciprocation, or you know, reproducing that is going to take some time. Because if you are a beginner, don't be hard on yourself. कि मुझे ये सिखाया है लेकिन मुझे ये नहीं आ रहा है, दैट इज़ फाइन, बिकॉज वी आर नॉट यूज टू दिस. वी आर यूज टू बींग वेरी नेचुरल अराउंड यू नो इन आर डे टू डे लाइफ. सो अभिनय इज गोइंग टू रिक्वायर अ लॉट ऑफ प्रैक्टिस. मैम टेल समथिंग अबाउट गतनिकास प्लीज, वेरी वेल एक्सप्लेन्ड अबाउट एक्सप्रेशंस. थैंक यू वरदा. अबाउट गतनिकास प्लीज रेफर टू माई पोस्ट. I've given all the details there. Ma'am, please tell us about chakras and the correct technique. Okay. Improvement in chakras. Yes. Chakras. Okay. So everybody is about chakras. For chakras, one thing is you have to, again, we are coming back to the focal point. So focal point hamara peeche kabhi bhi nahi chhodne wala hai. So look at yourself in the mirror, that is the best way, okay? And hit your foot, hit the right foot, and you're going to turn on the heel of the left foot for the ek pair ki chakkar. So just like a top, which a top ya bhavra isko hindi mein bolte hain. Inception movie dekhi hogi to usme end mein wo ghoomta rehta hai. So it is, you know, balancing on one single point, that is the axis. So this is your axis, that single point is the heel of your left foot, your axis is over here. Okay, ye seedhe axis pe aap ghumoge. Now hit the foot and push the floor and come in front. So when you come in front, ये जो पैर है ना ये आपको नीचे रखना है ताकि आप ब्रेक मार सको. दिस इज द ब्रेक दैट यू आर गोइंग टू डू. सो वन एंड टू एंड थ्री एंड फोर एंड सो दिस एंड इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, विदाउट लेटिंग योर राइट फुट टच द फ्लोर प्रैक्टिस दिस वन एंड टू एंड ब्रेक मारना जो है द बैलेंसिंग पार्ट इज गोइंग टू बी टेकन केयर ऑफ बाय द लेफ्ट फुट कंप्लीटली. The right foot is only going to, you know, help you, you hit the right foot on the beat and it's going to help you with pushing the floor. You push the floor back and that is how you're going to turn. Now, second thing is whenever you're turning, your body frame should be compact. You can't turn this way. As in you can, but then the resistance of the air is going to increase. So that is going to make your chakras more difficult. One more thing is if you're doing a two pair ki chakkar, do pair ki chakkar, one, two. Make sure that two is stepping where, you know, in the direction of where you're going. Take your body and turn. That is one more tip I would like to give. Please don't turn this way. My body is straight, the foot is in front and I'm starting to turn. Don't do that. Take your body and turn. Okay, so one, two. One, two. Now the axis has changed to the heel of the right foot, if you observed, okay? I am stepping and I am pushing with my left, turning on the right heel of the right foot and stepping with the left again. So that is how, jitne bhi pair ki chakkar hai, do pair ki chakkar hai, teen pair ki chakkar hai, you are going to have to learn to find the axis, ke axis mera jo hai wo right heel pe hai ya left heel pe hai. And then you're going to have to work on your balance. Chakkars, correct technique, done. Chakkars, okay. Some tips for padhant. We have to learn Shastra in Hindi and English. So can we use Marathi? Yes, you can use Marathi also, of course. You can just translate the Shastra. Taking spins on heels give burning sensation because of friction. How to deal with it? Maybe your skin is sensitive. You can try to powder it. Maybe I used to use some talcum powder so that my feet do not stick to the floor. This burning sensation is really because of the friction that what you have said. So you have to reduce the friction in order to reduce that burning sensation. Okay, so coming to the padhant question, for padhant you have to start in a speed where you can pronounce all the syllables clearly. For example, ghe ghe na na titikata gadigana dha. So if I can say ghe ghe na na titikata gadigana dha a, 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 and so on. So start itne kam samay mein itna speed mat reach karo, try to, you know, increase the speed gradually. You can use a timer ke 2 minute mein I'm going to say it in this speed, after this I'm going to increase it a little bit, after that I'm going to increase it a little bit. That you can do. Second thing is you have to really practice your R and G. G should come from here, especially when you say tigda dig dig, because I know people saying tia didi thai, tia didi thai, tia didi thai, because they are not used to saying G, tigda dig dig. ये प्रैक्टिस ही नहीं हुई है. सो डोंट डू दैट. से द ग साउंड फ्रॉम हियर, तिगदा दिग दिग, तिगदा दिग दिग थई, तिगदा दिग दिग थई, तिगदा दिग दिग थई. तो ग साउंड यहाँ से आना चाहिए कोई भी लय में आप बोलो. एंड सेकंड इज र. यू कैन प्रैक्टिसिंग धिर धिर किड तक, धिर धिर किड तक, सो दैट र साउंड आना चाहिए. इससे आप अच्छे से पढ़ने की प्रैक्टिस कर सकते हो. सो व्हेन आई वाज in my master's degree or I don't know, maybe younger than that, I used to eat ice cream ताके जो tongue है ना थोड़ा थोड़ी सी weight उसका बढ़ जाता है because you are eating something which is very cold and then I used to practice the padhant. Okay, for example, if I am saying which bowl kardin karda tit tar kit dik ta git kit thun thun na tit ta kit na tir kit dir dir kit na da dir kit din so tir kit dir dir kit na da kit na dir dir kit na that dir dir kit na that ra should come. If that ra doesn't come, tik ta dik na da kit na dik kit na, then the you know us bowl mein kuch maza nahi hai. So that is a good thing. That where in Pune do you take live classes? Actually in Pune we had three branches, one in Karve Nagar, one in Kalyani Nagar and one in Baner, but right now, as of now, up till December, no live classes are going to happen. All classes have shifted online. Where to reach you? I mean your posts and stuff. You can follow me on my Instagram page. I think Nritya Rupam ke page pe mera Instagram ID rahega. Tell us about Theka. Okay. What would you like to know about Theka? Because Theka is a very broad concept. Most welcome, Shreya. Kriti, if you can, you know, please elaborate your question. Tell us about Theka. So I'll just start by giving the background. Every taal has a fixed number of beats, that we know. Okay, so every beat has a unique name associated with it and which makes up the theka of the taal. So theka of your taal, every theka is going to be unique. So if I say let's do dhina dhi dhina today, it's taken for granted that dhina dhi dhina matlab humko jhaptal karna hai. If I say let's do dhina dhi dhina today, nobody is going to think that achha shayad trital karna hai, teen taal karna hai, rupak karna hai, pata nahi kya karna hai. Aise nahi hoga. Dhina dhi dhina is associated with jhap taal. So every taal is going to have its unique theka. And for us to be, you know, for us to make it easier to count the cycle, we divide this theka into small groups. So if you're seeing teen taal, so we have four groups of four matras each. In jhaptal we have 2 3 2 3, so that theka is going to vary. There are some taals whose you know the thekas differ. For example, shikhar taal. Shikhar taal which I had learned from Shambhavi Tai was different, and the Shikhar taal which I learned under Guru, my Guru Rajendra Gangani ji, was different. The theka was different. The you know division of the theka was also different. So that that may keep on changing. That is just apne apne Guru parampara ke anusar alag alag ho sakta hai. Can we register? Can we take your online classes? How do we register? You can visit my profile and you can just, you know, drop me a DM, or and you can visit my website skilshruti.com, skillshruti.com. You can visit there and you can contact me. How can strong lay and taal part, how to improve our focus on lay? To improve your focus on lay, what I do is I play the teen taal theka. And you know, even during the day when I'm cooking or when I'm cleaning, I just play the teen taal theka and I keep listening to the theka. Nothing else. Mera kaam bhi acche se ho jata hai aur wo lay bhi mere dimag mein chalti rehti hai. Ma'am, many people tell us that putting the Nataraja idol at home isn't right. Is it true? I do not believe in this because har ek ke belief ke anusar hota hai. But I don't believe I have a Nataraja idol in my home. And you know, मुझे तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है अगर मैं Nataraj को देखती हूँ. It gives me motivation. So you know, it's just a matter of belief. Any more questions? I guess that's it. I can just, you know, leave a comment maybe with my ID and you guys can visit my profile. I don't know whether that that is possible. See, ma'am, how you define Kathak for males? Okay, how to make different sounds of low and high pitch according to the bowl using foot. Nikita, okay, Kathak for males, one of my colleagues, strongly believes that Kathak is a male dance. जो हम फीमेल्स ने ऐसे एनक्रोच करके रखा है उसके ऊपर. ऑफ कोर्स दिस जस्ट अ फन पार्ट, बट मेल डांसर्स ब्रिंग अ वेरी गुड एनर्जी टू द डांस. एंड एज वी से शिव शक्ति दोनों एलिमेंट्स होने चाहिए. तो हर अगर मेल डांस कर रहा है तो उनके एक्सप्रेशंस में जब वो राधा दिखा रहा है तो वो थोड़ा फेमिनिटी होना चाहिए. और अगर मैं डांस कर रही हूँ तो अगर मैं लॉर्ड कृष्णा दिखा रही हूँ तो उसमें मुझ में थोड़ी मैस्कुलिनिटी होनी चाहिए. बिकॉज एज आई सेड, इफ आई डोंट बिलीव इट, माई ऑडियंस इज नॉट गोइंग टू बिलीव इट. आई डोंट हैव तालमाला एट होम, सो हाउ कैन आई प्रैक्टिस ऑन लय? यू कैन डाउनलोड द रिदम ऐप विच इज देयर ऑन दी प्ले स्टोर. इट्स अ फ्री ऐप, वो यूज कर सकते हो. एंड वन मोर थिंग, वेन आई वॉज स्मॉल वी डिडंट हैव तालमालाज बैक देन, जब हम लोग स्कूल में थे. तो आई यूज टू जस्ट प्ले एनी रैंडम सॉन्ग, बॉलीवुड सॉन्ग ऑब्वियसली, क्योंकि तब रेडियो रहता था या फिर कैसेट प्लेयर्स रहते थे. चित्रहार लगता था इस पे हर संडे टीवी पे. सो द अकॉर्डिंग टू द ठेका ऑफ दैट सॉन्ग आई यूज टू प्रैक्टिस. ओके, सो आई एम गोइंग टू आंसर मैथिली एंड निकिताज क्वेश्चंस टुगेदर हियर. And I think we just have about five or six more minutes before the session ends. So, Nikita, while hitting the foot, you have to learn to balance your energy. आप कितना कितने एनर्जी से पैर मार रहे हो, कितने फोर्स से पैर मार रहे हो, इज गोइंग टू डिफर. ओके, सो इफ एज एन एग्जाम्पल यू कैन स्टार्ट विथ द बेसिक बांड. ओके, दिस इज वेयर यू स्टार्टेड. नाउ ट्राई कि हर तत् का जो साउंड है ना वो सेम आना चाहिए थ्रू आउट, और वो बाकी के इससे ज्यादा होना चाहिए. सो मे बी यू यू कैन ट्राई जोर से मारो, जोर से मारो, जोर से मारो. ओके, तो ये जो है एनर्जी लेवल का डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन आपको प्रैक्टिस करना पड़ेगा. कीप डूइंग वन पैटर्न फॉर लॉन्गर ड्यूरेशन ऑफ टाइम. तो मैं मेरे ट्यूटोरियल वीडियोस में भी मैं बताती हूँ दैट कीप डूइंग वन थिंग. मे बी 10 मिनट्स का टाइमर लगाओ और एक ही हस्तक करो, 10 मिनट्स का टाइमर लगाओ, एक ही फुट पैटर्न करो. ओके, सो दैट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प यू. एंड फॉर मैथिली, आप अलग अलग सॉन्ग्स ये कर सकते हो. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अगर आपने लिया तकिटे की आपको प्रैक्टिस करनी है तो टेक सम सॉन्ग विच गोज बाय 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2 3, एट द टॉप ऑफ माई माइंड. अभी ना जाओ छोड़ कर के दिल अभी बनाने हैं. 1 2 3, 1 2 3, कीप प्रैक्टिसिंग दैट. 1 2 3, 1 2 3, 1 2 3. देर आर मेनी सॉन्ग्स विच गो बाय द रिदम 4. देन देर आर सम सॉन्ग्स विच गो बाय 3 4, विच विल बी रूपक 3 एंड 4. ओके, सो दैट इज गोइंग टू रियली हेल्प यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट ताल बेटर. ओके, आई थिंक दैट्स इट. आई थिंक आई हैव आंसर्ड ऑल ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस एंड द सेशन माइट एंड सून. सो इफ यू हैव एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस जस्ट शूट. अच्छा, सो हाउ डू आई सेव दिस, हाउ डू आई सेव द वीडियो? आई डोंट नो. मोस्ट वेलकम, मोस्ट वेलकम मैथिली. कथककार, मे आई नो योर नेम? Do you conduct online classes? Yes, Pranali, I conduct online classes. You can just visit my profile and send me a DM, or I will just share my number here. You can contact me over WhatsApp. That's my number. Nitya Rupam ke account se maine bheja hai. Sakshi Mishra, hi Sakshi. Nice talking to you. Ek tukda present kela tar kharas khub chhan vatel. Shreya. Okay. So we will just end the session with a small tukda. Let me think which one. I need a tukda which, you know, I can do it in that much space क्योंकि कैमरा का एंगल उतना ही है. ओके आई विल शेयर IGTV. ओके फाइन फाइन आई क्लिक ऑन दैट ऑप्शन. थैंक यू सो मच. सो दीना. Thank you everybody. Thank you. Thank you so much for your wishes. Thank you. And so every Monday I have a special segment on my Instagram which is called Sawali Somvar. You can ask me your Kathak related questions over there, theory and practical related questions, and I will address them, you know, over the week. Usually I just like to answer all the questions on Monday itself. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. It's been great talking to all of you. And thank you, Nritya Rupam, for providing me with this opportunity to connect with so many people. So many beautiful people. Great. Okay, so I think I'll see you, see some of you on my followers list on Instagram, and some of you even in my class if you plan to register. Okay, great. It was, thank you Shreya, it was great talking to everybody. Stay home, stay safe, and I hope everybody is doing fine. And even apart from Kathak, anything you want to, you know, say, I'm always there to hear everybody out. You know, sometimes talking to strangers just helps. So, you can just DM me anytime you want. Okay, guys, bye. See you.